He just walks the.
Yeah, why is prisoner of Azkaban?
Harry Potter.
We're listening?
Guys,
maybe. Let's just work the whole thing through, because I think that you guys are doing really well. So rather than having you work on it more, I think you guys are ready to just have this part be done. So we're going to plug in these values for x. We're going to see what comes out. And then we're going to see a little more that's going to help us understand something about graphs. All right. So we're going to take a number. And this is what I highly, highly suggest that you do, along with looking up here, is that you, when you want to work this out, when you plug a number for x, okay, take out the x, replace the x with parentheses. Wherever you see an x, put parentheses. Because the parentheses is a good visual aid of what x is. It's just an empty spot for a number to come in. Okay? So x, parentheses, squared, minus 2 times x, plus 1. So now what are we going to plug in for x the first time?
Hey,
everybody.
Hey.
Chill out.
Chill.
I'm going to take distractions out in the hallway. I don't want to do that. It's not fun. Negative 2 squared. What does it mean to square a number?
Times it by itself.
Okay, what is the number? We're going to multiply by itself.
Negative 2.
So the next step is going to look like?
2 times negative 2
again. Okay, the next part is we're going to subtract 2 times negative 2 when you subtract a negative. What is that? Subtracting
a positive.
Or a negative times a negative is positive. Right? Positive what?
Positive 4.
Plus 1. All right, now we have negative 2 times negative 2. I hope you know this because we just did it, negative 2 times negative 2. But for different reasons. This was because we were squared, and this is just because we happen to have a negative 2 times this negative 2. 4 plus 4 plus 1.
9.
8 plus 1.
Yeah.
Now we do it again, but we do it with a different number. So all this stuff is going to look a little different. But we can just take it back to the two blanks, right? The blank squared and negative 2 times the blank. Negative 1 in there. Negative 1 squared is 1. Negative 2 times negative 1 is 2. What's 1?
4.
So 4.
What?
Whisper.
Now we don't even need to. Now we don't even need to waste ink on this next one.
It's just one.
Calm down. All right. Because you are getting, it doesn't mean everybody's getting everything that you're getting. And it doesn't mean that you're getting everything that everybody else is getting. So give everybody a chance to hear each explanation. When we plug in 0, what's going to be 0 times itself?
0
times 0 is 0. And what's negative 2 times 0?
0
times 0 again is 0. So this is all 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is just 1. When we have a function with all these x terms in it, and then somewhere in there, we just have a number with no x being multiplied. Well, all the stuff with x in it must go away, go to 0. And we're just left with whatever that number is that was like, lucky enough to not be multiplied by an x. All right, so we're playing a 1. 1 squared minus 2 times 1. What's 1 squared?
1.
Minus 2 times 1.
2.
Minus 2. 1. 1 minus 2 is negative 1 plus 1. 0, or 1 plus 1 is 2, minus 2 is 0, negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1, plus 1 is 0, we get 0, however we try to add those together. Alright, 2 is the next one, 2 times 2 is 4. What's negative 2 times 2?
Negative 4.
Negative 4, so that's just going to cancel each other out. So when we add 1, we're left with?
1.
4 minus 4 is 0, plus 1. Last is a 3. 3 squared minus 2 times 3. 3 squared?
9.
9. negative two times three.
Negative
six. So you get a minus six.
Oh, yeah. That's
one,
four.
Nine minus six, three.
Four.
One.
Four.
Four.
I only
dropped. Straight on the dollar.
I should say one because I'm sure
how to
do.
How was 9 minus 6?
Kelly, alfalfa.
9.
What?
9 5, 6.
That's 3?
But
oh,
nine
oh you're right.
Their math is so terrible.
No, 9 minus 6 is a negative.
Alright.
Here we go.
You're taking 9 away from 6.
No, you're taking 6 away from 9.
So negative.
Oh, Lord.
9 minus
6,
six is
away
3.
From
9. Oh, it's confusing.
You got it?
Yeah.
Okay, buddy.
Okay.
It's okay, Kelly.
Okay.
It's okay, everybody. Chill.
It's a lot of math to do very quickly, so
yeah.
Beat yourself up about it.
Kelly's fault.
We'll get it.
Okay. So now what we're going to do, like I said, let's put away our reading books. Appreciate a lot for reading, but let's be in the math class, Kelly. Here is, you know, let's just call it some graph paper. Actually, just a little technicality. It's not a graph. Like, this is not a graph. It's not a graph until I draw a graph. This is like graph paper. Or it's the plane. It's the place where graphs live, but it is not a graph. So that's not a graph. I have not put a graph on there yet. It isn't a graph until I draw a graph. It's just graph paper or a plane. So let me get some help from somebody. I'm going to hand this off to someone. And they're going to plot the first point.
This chick.
I'm going to give it to Colby first.
Yeah.
So I was going to go first. Now you got to do it with this. If you can't do it with this.
Colby, you're going to do
it
wrong.
Okay, plot the first point. Negative 2, 9. X is negative 2.
You can't go all the way
like,
down.
Yeah, come down.
X is
negative
2.
You
ding? Oh, ding. Right? This is the x-axis.
Yep.
So our x value is negative 2. And so on the x-axis, we should see negative 2.
No.
Oh my God.
What?
Negative
2
and
9.
That's a
highlight.
No.
This is an eraser right here.
All
right.
Am I on it?
Right there,
man.
Get your butt together.
No. Yep. Good job. You got this, man.
Colby, you got it, bud.
Okay.
Can
okay,
you do the next
thing?
Wrong.
Wouldn't it be me?
Okay.
Right here, right?
No.
No.
But it's
okay,
dude,
the
negative
x axis is negative 2 and the y is 9.
It
says
I'm not choosing. Colby's choosing.
Oh,
it's right here.
No.
Wait a minute.
That's the x. No. Go to the x, negative 2, right there, see?
The 9 up.
But since y is the 9, you go 9 up.
I love my color.
Closer.
Right there.
Right.
Holy Jesus. Sorry.
It's okay,
Colby.
Nice try.
Lots of practice.
It's okay.
Be proficient.
I feel you.
Jasper. I can see the potatoes on.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Pick
someone.
Someone really help me out.
What?
Yeah.
Really, Colby? I said that you were my favorite
cousin.
No,
I'm
Mexican version.
And I told people that I love you and you were my favorite cousin ever.
Whoa.
All right, so you got Hunter's next.
No more.
Check
mark. You hover over.
Oh.
Why are they got a nice looking point there?
This is.
I chose somebody else now, Colby, to meet my cousin.
Cool.
Apparently, you're not my favorite.
All right.
His name is me.
Yeah, right.
Especially Smith.
You were prepared for the worst.
Smith, whatever.
It's true.
house? How did they do that?
Not Smith.
Alright, so Brandon's wrapping 0, 1. X is 0 and Y is 1.
I said give it to Kelly.
Use my phone.
Which one? Schmidt? Good.
Which one? So, Brandon just did 0, 1, 0, 1, 0.
Oh.
It's upset. There
you go.
You got it.
Whoa.
You hover your pen up around the top left, that's where the screen is.
Oh! Okay.
That's cool. Yeah. Like,
alright, so Olivia's gonna plot 1, 0.
1 on X.
One.
You got this.
Why don't you put it down on the table? And then
that's what I did.
Olivia!
What?
Yes,
right.
Erase that.
You got it!
You got it!
Got
it.
Right. Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. 1, 0. X is 1.
Give it to Kelly.
Y is 0. You can rest your hand on it.
Yeah.
Sit. You can rest your hand on it just like you would normally.
Yeah.
Why did you say no?
Oh, yesterday.
Just hop
it's on the
left hand.
Oh.
Okay,
got it.
I had
gone. Oh my gosh.
What did you do to Sydney?
Okay,
2-1.
Sid is on 2-1.
2?
12.
I see it.
Yeah.
So they're good.
Last one. Sid, make more selection.
Sydney, choose Kelly.
Sydney.
Yay!
Oh,
I
tried.
Yeah, thank you, David.
Alright. Samantha's gonna grab 3-4.
Every time we went to my church, you were in the front. Could you stop doing
my
that?
My grass is way better.
Alright.
That's so mean.
Our dogs are on my team.
Are they connected?
Or like the last connected.
Oh, well, that's actually the question we're going to answer right now. We're going to look at different
things. I got hands. Oh, different.
Alright, now. Ladies and gentlemen. Please stop talking.
Okay.
Stop talking.
Alright, so the next natural question that I get a lot, I'm going to help you see that it's kind of a silly question. The question of how do we connect these points? Okay. Now, I've said this many times. A graph is not points and the shape that connects those points. It's not a coloring book.
Oh.
It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and you connect it with the shape. Okay? Now it looks like, if you watch somebody graph a graph with points and then connect it, it looks like that's what's happening. Okay? But if you want to know how they're connected, you just need to understand that what we've just done is graph some of the graph and not other parts of the graph. Right? I made you plug in those x values. What x values could you have plugged in?
Anything
you want.
Anything.
Okay. Now this is a nice collection of points. It certainly seems like a shape is there.
Big Dipper.
Okay. But let's see what that shape is by understanding what the graph is. Okay. When you go to connect those points, that shape that you connect it with is just a bunch of more points. So if you want to know how they connect, you need to either find more points or make a reasonable guess where those points are. And if you can reasonably guess where the rest of the points are between these points and beyond these points, well, that's what it's going to look like when you connect them, okay? Even though we're not really connecting. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
It's not about connecting. It's about just knowing where the rest of the points should be. Right.
Yeah.
So, to make that point even further in a different way, here we have x of 2 and an x of 3. Now, slide that over. There's an x of 2.1. What could you say about 2.1, which is almost, you can almost see it, the way that I just slid that over.
It'd be pretty close to it.
Okay.
three and four would be?
It'd be really close to two.
Okay. So a few things we're saying here. 2.1 is, I think the point that we're just kind of taking it for granted and is just obvious, is that 2.1 is between 2 and 3, right? I made it easier to see because I set it up that way. When I slid that over, it even on the table looks to be between 2 and 3. And we know it is between 2 and 3. 2.1 is bigger than 2 is smaller. Okay. So let's just start out. Maybe you have some guesses about what it's going to be. I love guesses. But just keep your guesses to yourself. And you know what the work looks like. We just did it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different times with 6 different numbers, right? Very similar things happen. This number times itself. We got -2 times this number. We got +1. Put it all together. We get the y value. But now with 2.1, it'd probably be easier to use your calculators, right? So if you got a phone, you got a calculator. If you have a calculator, you certainly have a calculator. If you don't have a calculator, you can, rely on other people to do the work for you. If you go grab a calculator from over here, sign one out, or grab one of your calculators. Okay, let's see if we can get a few people to tell me what the y value is, right, and have them agree. All right, so let's take a good 7 seconds here, plug that into your calculator, see if we can get some agreement. Yes, 1.21 is what we would get if we plug in 2.1. Okay, let's talk about a couple of things. First, we said a second ago, 2.1 is between 2 and 3. Right? X value of 2 and x value of 3. The x value of 2, when I plug it in, what do I get? 1. It's written right there. When I plug in 3, what do I get out?
4.
So, if I plug in a number between 2 and 3, 2.1, what do you notice about the number that you get out?
4.1.
What is it between?
2 and 3.
1.21 between 2 and 3?
1 and 2.
It is between 1 and 2, but it's also between 1 and 4. Just kind of basing it off of the work that we've already done, would you be surprised if when you plug in 2, you get 1, when you plug in 3, you get 4. So if I plug in something between 2 and 3, I would get out something between 1 and 4. Is that surprising?
No.
No, not surprising. Okay. So that's not always the case, but certainly does not surprise me that going in between 2 and 3 gives me a number between 1 and 4.
So weird.
Now let's slide this over again. Let's try it again at 2.2.
Oh my god, no!
All right, 1.44. There it is. Now, calm down, everyone. What do we notice about 2.2? 2.2 is between
2.1 and 3.
Not only is it between 2 and 3, it's between 2.1 and 3. Like, we're kind of narrowing that gap. Get it?
Don't do it again.
Do you need to take a break in the hall? Or? Next person I have to talk to directly is going to go in the hallway for a little breather. Okay, 2.2. It's the next value. It's between 2.1 and 3. When I plug in 2.1, I get 1.21. When I plug in 3, I get 4. So look at 1.44. It's between
1.21
and 4. Surprising?
Nope.
Not surprising, right? When we plug in an x value between two x values, we get out a y value that's between the corresponding y values. Right, let's keep seeing this connection.
1.69.
Hey!
Oh, see, I tricked you.
2.23.
Oh, what? That's what I have for x. So just so you can see, we should have 2.23 times 2.23 minus 2 times 2.23. What's the last part?
Plus one.
Okay. So these calculators most of these scientific ones can do it all in one line. Yeah, you hit enter, it does it all at once. Which means you gotta be careful that you give it the right instructions. It's gonna follow the order of operations as we discussed earlier this year. 2 and T. It is not not gonna deviate at all from that order of operations. We make sure that it does those things in the right order. It does these, we did the exponent first. It's gonna do this multiplication of negative 2 times 2.23 as its own little thing. It's gonna multiply these together. Then it'll add everything together, including the negative numbers. 1.51.
Oh,
that's right.
What?
2.53 and 3. We plug in 3, we get 4, so you think this will be what? Somewhere between 2.23 and 3. Right? This number right here will be 3.
Oh, so between 1.5 and 1.24
and 4.
1.809025.
Give it off the chart.
Yeah.
What is that?
Now, I'm gonna slide this over. I don't know. I'm gonna reveal one more number, but I want you to just chill out. Don't do anything with your calculators when I show you what this number is. I want to talk to you about what we're gonna expect. Right. So the number I'm gonna put up here is.
Are you kidding me?
2.99. Don't plug it in your calculators yet. Just hold off. 2.99999999. Okay. Now, that number is obviously between 2.345 and 3. It's between 2 and 3. But it's even more specific. It's really, really close to what?
3.
3.
So close to 3.
3, 4, whatever.
If, you know, round it up just a little bit, you're at 3. Now, if that number that we're about to plug into this function is really close to 3, what do you think this number will be really close to?
4.
Close to 4. If plugging in 3 gets you 4, then plugging a number really close to 3 should get you a number that's really close to 4.
Yeah.
I mean, like 3.
I did it.
3 point something. Probably 3.9 something. It's maybe lots of numbers. Notice this real quick. Maybe you've already done it, but also notice that 2.1 is a number that's, yes, it's between 2 and 3. It's very close to 2. When I plug in 2, I get 1. When I plug in 2.1, very close to 2, I get 1.21, which is very close to 1. Just a little bit bigger than that. So, James, what do you got?
9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9
actually, if it's a calculator, and the number was actually 3.999, like forever, depending on, well, it's not 3.9 forever, that's a problem. But if it was 3.9 forever, it would just repeat, it would just report back 4. It would just round up to 4. Which isn't actually the whole truth, it's not really a blanket. But even if it was like 3 point, and there was like 100 nines that were supposed to be there, it would again round up to 4. If it's like 12 nines, it's just going to stop at 9. Okay? It's not going to round up at that point.
I'm sorry,
Mark.
Welcome to Have a good day. Merry Hanukkah.